Don has a few knee issues.
Just one knee issue.
Just one knee. We call it the granny knee.
My granny knee.
Does anyone else have any other issues? Your chest, you said, was pretty tight today.
Okay, the other day.
We're going to be doing a lot of heart openers today, so that definitely should help.
Any issues going on with you then?
Yeah, why would you call the granny knee? I'm just...
I'm a granny.
Oh, okay. So I mean, as we age, we call this one
right,
Uncle Harry.
Exactly.
And
just because I don't take too many things seriously.
Because she would hobble, you know, a little bit. All right, having a seat in the easy pose. I'm going to take a few minutes and work on our breath. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to soften our gaze. Maybe even closing our eyes. And just checking in with that breath today. Maybe for the first time today, maybe for the first time this week. Bringing our awareness back around to the room. We're going to do a couple of alternate nostril breaths. So making like chakras with our fingers. Thumb out, fingers in the middle folded, pinky out. We're going to place one lightly on the right nostril and one on the left nostril. So go ahead and we're going to use the thumb to close off the right nostril. We're going to breathe in through the left. Holding at the top, taking the pinky and closing off the left nostril and letting the air come out the right nostril. Inhaling back through the right nostril. Holding at the top, closing off the right nostril and down through the left. Up the left. Your next right in and out, exhaling through the left nostril, releasing the hands to the left. Again, taking a moment to notice your breath. Notice if there's any shift in your breath, any changes. Maybe our energy has calmed down a little bit. And bringing awareness back to the room, placing our hands on our knees. That is a really good one to do at home, in traffic, if you're feeling stressed, just kind of taking a moment and becoming aware of our breath. Let us be a little nicer to the person in front of us. We're going to go ahead and roll our shoulders frontwards at first. And backwards. Your hands don't have to be stagnant on the knees. They can move along with the shoulders. Body to neutral. We're going to take our right hand up and over, stretching our center side body. I'm going to inhale to the top. And take the left side. Exhale. Taking out those knees. Bringing our body back into our easy pose. Checking in again for those sit bones, rounded into the mat. Sitting up as tall as possible. We're going to bring our arms out wide to the side, taking our right hand across the body, placing it on the floor behind us. Taking a big, deep breath as we lengthen that spine and exhale, turning as far as we can behind. Four breaths here. Swinging those arms back around to neutral, and taking it off to the other side. Checking in with that spine, lengthening, crown of the head up towards the sky. Big exhale, turning behind, four breaths. Important to help. back to center. Just a little bit of movement again in our shoulders. Forwards, backwards. Bringing ourselves to our mat. Taking it to tabletop. Grabbing a blanket for your knees if you would like. Double the blanket up for a little bit more of the cushion. Bringing our hands, fingers as wide as we can. This will help support us in our tabletop. Bringing our shoulders over top of our wrist. Taking a few minutes to check in here. On our next inhale, we're going to curve the tailbone up, bringing the heart up towards the sky, doing a few cat-cows. And exhale, curve that spine up towards the ceiling, tucking that tailbone, pulling that chin in as we exhale. And inhale. More at your own pace. Great job, guys. Keeping those shoulders away from the ears. As we go up in cat, pulling those shoulder blades away from each other. Toes together, and we're going to exhale it down to child's pose. Taking a few breaths here just to relax. Good job. If you'd like, you can place a blanket underneath your bottom.
Oh.
And just kind of gives you a little bit more support.
Okay.
So you can relax a little bit more. Holding for a few more breaths. Your next exhale, making our way up and back to our mat, removing any props out of our way, keeping our double blocks handy. And now that you're all settled, we're going to make our way to the top. That's life for us, right? One minute we think everything's good, and then it's time to move again. Okay, we're going to start out with Tadasana. So, we're going to check in with all four points of our feet. Underneath the ball of the feet of the big toe, little toe, two points in the heel. We're just going to kind of move back and forth. Forward, maybe doing some rounds. Hands on your hips, hands in prayer, wherever you feel comfortable. Shaking out our knees real quick, keeping those feet grounded, rooted down into the earth. Checking in with our knees, nice soft micro bend in our knees. We're going to take our tailbone and turn it down towards the floor. When we do that, you can feel your belly button coming right up. Rolling our shoulders back and down away from our ears. Crown of the head up tall. Hands out to the side. Taking a few breaths right here. This is the foundation of all yoga postures right here. Be aware of small contractions in the body, different types of feelings here. And rest. All right. A few minutes of rest. movements here. Exhaling, inhaling. Letting the arms nice and loose, kind of just turning to the side. Good job. All right, today we're going to do a balanced posture, the tree pose. I'm going to teach you how to do three different variations of it. So we're going to go check and back into mountain pose. All the points of our feet on the floor. Slight bend in those knees. We're going to imagine where our belly button is, and we're going to take that over top of our right big toe. You feel a little shift when we do that? Bringing it back, and then again, shift on over, and bring it back, and then shift over. Now this time, all the weight in that right foot, we're going to slowly bring that left foot up into the side. Even if you can only pull your heel, perfect. Finding our drishti gaze, looking out in front. I'm in a spot on the floor. Now for our ones that serves you to bring it up a little higher, or maybe even all the way up, not putting any pressure on the knee itself. Hands up the side, prayer, maybe even full expression. Good job, guys. Couple breaths here. And slowly exhale, releasing out of that, shaking those legs up. Maybe even doing a little dance around. Good job. Finding our mountain pose again, feet rooted into that ground. Too much fun, right?
Damn. I'm tripping.
I like it. All right, locating that belly button again, bringing it off to the left, over top of that big toe, bringing it back, bringing it over to that big toe, always keeping a micro bend in those knees, never really just contracting that whole knee, bringing it to the middle, and last time, bringing the belly button over top of that toe, finding that drishti gaze, slowly bringing that foot up to where you feel comfortable. Finding a few breaths and bringing it on up. Arms out to the side.
Don't do that.
Tell the ego to go away. Doesn't matter where that foot is. Full expression. Making sure that knees out to the side. Doesn't matter if you're here or you're doing it. And release. Walking out, doing a couple circles. Good job. Next, we're going to bring our feet out nice and wide. Toes pointing directly at the front of the room. Yeah, you can do it on this side. Again, always keeping that slight bend in our knees. We're going to go into the triangle. Hands out. This one is a really good one for boosting the immune system. And we're going to grab a block if need be. You can always take away, so I always like to add up to where I am. Hands out, slowly dropping our body on down, taking away blocks if needed. Make sure that our chest is turned up towards the ceiling. Nice heart opener. A few breaths here. placing our hand down on the block together. If you need to, moving the block to the center. If not, just checking in here to the center. Using that right hand from the middle, shifting the hand over and bring that right hand up in the middle. Then bring that right hand down and take the left hand up. Opening that heart, chest open towards the ceiling. Bringing that left hand down and right hand up. And one more time on the left side. Bringing ourselves, hands on our hips, knees bent. Staying here for a few breaths. Nice flat back. Pushing through our heels and our legs, we're gonna come on up. Heel toe, heel toe. Bring it in, shake it out. Okay, bringing it on back out. Placing our blocks over on the opposite side. Hands out to our side. Exhale, bring our hand on down. Removing blocks if needed. Checking in with that chest, that it's turned up towards the ceiling. A few breaths here. Bringing that hand down to meet the other hand. Slowly walking to the middle, bringing your blocks with you if needed. Checking in with a nice slight bend in those knees. Placing the right hand in the middle on the block or the floor. Gonna inhale up. And exhale. Left hand down, inhale, right hand up. Exhale down, switching hands. Leading with that chest, we're going to have two more, one on each side. Again, meeting the hands together, one hand on each hip, taking a moment here in the middle. Inhale up as you push through the heels and those legs. And heel to toe, coming back in. You can move your blocks just off to the side. We'll need them again in a second. Shaking those legs out. Bringing back into the mountain pose and maybe bringing our blocks on over. We're going to do a forward fold. Checking in with all the points in our feet. Moving our knees back and forth. We're going to inhale our hands up. Exhale forward, folding on down to the floor to wherever you feel comfortable. Taking a few breaths here. Inhale, rooting through the ground with the legs to the top. Bringing our hands, exhaling the heart center. Good job. The longer that we can hold the forward fold or the big toe, I can show you that one next, the better it helps massage our organs and helps boost everything in our body. So we're going to do one more of those. Inhale up. Exhale, forward fold. For my ones that can reach their toes, you are welcome to take your peace fingers, placing one under your big toe, the other one under the other big toe. Make sure those shoulders are back away from the ears and releasing the head. On your next inhale, inhaling up slowly to the sky, reaching the rise. Exhale to prayer center. Taking a few moments just to give in a couple little movements, twisting. Turn the feet to a 45-degree angle, corners of the room. We're going to go ahead and turn to our right, taking our hands behind us, interlacing our fingers, leading with our chest, going down and slowly letting our arms fall behind us. Inhaling up, taking a few moments, make sure we're not dizzy, sometimes going upside down can cause stuff like that. Inhale, exhale over to the other side, slowly leading with that chest, and finally fully surrendering. That heel coming on up, moving in the middle, and one more on each side. Exhale, turning the navel towards the leg, and letting that head drop down, arms behind. Inhale up, quick breath here. Exhale to the other side. Inhaling up. Releasing the hands. A few movements in the shoulders. Interlacing to the front. And pushing out and away. Tucking that chin in as we exhale. Lowering those hands, heel to toe, coming up. Good job. Making our way to the floor. Awesome. Checking in here with our butterfly pose. Feet together. Wherever is comfortable for you. You can even take your blocks and place them under your knees. Yep, you can even put them up for high here so you're able to relax. And maybe as we go along, you can move them down. Great job. Yep, just tuck them right in. Let those legs, so you have a nice relaxed position. Finding those sit bones. Finding length in the spine. Head up. Exhale, taking our feet and opening them up like a book. Keeping that length in that spine. Head up high. And bringing those legs out in front, shaking it out. Taking our right leg, we have a stitch.
Yes.
From breathing and...
From trying to go forward.
Uh-huh. Go ahead and take...
I feel like a turtle. I just feel so small.
Just go ahead and take a few breaths lying all the way down. Doing the stretch where we take your hands up over your head. There we go. Bring your hands up your head and try to point your toes. And then bring your hands down. Good. And just do a couple of those. So inhale as you come up. And exhale as you come down. Bringing our right leg out to the side, left leg in towards the thigh. Checking in with that posture, we're going to turn our right navel. You guys do that. Sections of our navel. Walking our hands down. Checking in. Just make sure when we do this one to lead with your chest. Maybe it's the concaving that we were doing that was irritating that. So lead up with that chest. Even if you can only go to here, that's fine.
Okay.
Inhale, coming on up. Bringing it to center. And exhale, walking on down. This time, checking in with your next exhale so you can go a little farther. Finally dropping the head, staying here for 4 breaths. And slowly making our way back up. Turning to the middle, finding that length in the spine, nice and tall. Bringing our legs out front, shaking them out. Taking that left leg out to the side, bringing in that right to the thigh. Making sure our sit bones are comfortably on the ground. Inhale, exhale, that left navel, on down. Taking a few breaths there. I did the right one, I had to try to do the left one. Then it became nasal, not navel. Inhale, walking our hands back up, returning to center, lengthening that spine, the crown of the head up high. Inhale, exhale, over to the side, walking those hands down to where you feel comfortable, weaving out with that chest up towards the ceiling, shoulders back and away from our ears. On your next exhale, try to go a little farther, and go ahead and fully release that head down for 4 breaths. One more moment, hands to the side, lengthen that spine, head up towards the ceiling. And release. Grabbing any blankets or anything that you would need for your head, we're going to make our way to our backs. taking our right leg out in front, bringing our left leg across our body, placing it on the floor if you can. If not, you can build some blocks underneath that knee. Just kind of releasing right here. You can roll your body to the side, not having to keep the buttocks on the floor. Inhale up to the top, releasing those legs. Bringing up the right one this time and just rolling it over to the side. Inhaling up, releasing both legs straight. Picking up that left one and bringing it across the body. One more time on each side. Inhale up, releasing the leg all the way down. Right leg up and over the body. And bringing it back to the mat. Legs out. Arms up overhead. Stretching that body as far away from each other as you can. Pointing those toes, stretching those fingers. We're going to exhale, bringing both our knees up to our chest, squeezing in. Inhale, bringing that body as far away from hands and feet. Again, exhale, bringing the knees to chest. And straightening out that body. And do a few of these at your own pace. Matching our breath to our movement. Meeting with our legs stretched out, arms to the side. We're going to roll over onto our right side using our arm as a pillow, taking a few seconds here in the fetal position. Making our way up to the top. Moving our blankets, straps, and our blocks. Making our way on over. We are going to do legs up the wall. So you're going to find a place on the wall. Placing your mat close to the wall. Having a seat on the mat slightly scooch each time, bringing your feet and buttocks towards the wall. This is an amazing posture to do at night before bed. It helps recirculate. It's okay, sometimes it takes a while. Go ahead and push your shoulders into the mat and scoot your butt forward.
Have you ever watched kids watch TV? They watch it like this.
Yes.
I
used to do that when I was little. Ideal time for legs up the wall is about 4 minutes. We're going to practice that now. Hands at your side, shoulders nice and relaxed. Your body's recirculating your blood, bringing fresh oxygen and blood up towards your head. I'm going to slowly come around and put a sandbag on your feet. It'll help ground you down a little bit more. If you don't want a sandbag, place your hand on your heart. Any thoughts that come up, acknowledge them and send them away. Concentrate on your breath here. Let your body do the work. Got about 2 more minutes here. Bringing your awareness back to the room, slowly lowering your feet and carefully removing the sandbag. Staying here, bringing your feet back up the wall, placing your right hand on your right thigh, allow the right leg to kind of just fall off to the side. Nice hip opener. Staying here for a few seconds, and you can use that hand to kind of hold that leg. Using that hand, push the leg back on up to the top. And taking the left one off to the side. And pushing that left leg on up. Taking a moment to readjust those hips. And letting that right leg fall off to the side. Inhaling up to the top, taking a second here, bringing our feet together, slowly sliding them down the wall, and sitting in like a butterfly position at the wall. Knees out to the side, putting our hands on our knees, and pushing the legs towards the wall if that serves you today. Inhale, bringing our legs up the wall. Now we are ready for Shavasana. If you would like to stay in your legs up the wall, you are more than welcome to. I can come by and re-put the sandbag onto your feet. If not, you can scoot yourself off laying flat on the mat. You're even welcome to do the frog pose that we just did for your Shavasana. Any props or anything that you would need to relax. If you would like me to put your sandbag back on your feet, go ahead and put your hand on your tummy. Or just look at me. All right, I'm going to go around shutting the lights off. We're going to check in.
Well, yeah, maybe I'll try it.
Okay, yeah, and then you can,
yeah.
Just be careful. Got it?
Yes.
All right. It's time to check in and do nothing. Relaxing our feet. Relaxing down our knees, especially focusing here on the tops of our thigh bones, just letting them release a little bit more. Tummy is soft. Shoulders melting into the floor. Bringing our face muscles as soft as we can make them. Hands nice and relaxed down to each fingertip. Letting that jaw go and the tongue drop from the roof. Nothing left to do but be Shavasana.
appreciate showing up on your mat today. And when you're ready, making your way on up to the top, eyes closed. Our hands to the sides of our legs. One last big inhale up to the top. And exhale down, stopping out our mouth, that we only speak kindness and love from this moment forward. And bringing it down to our center. Hope to appreciate yourself.